boys May Long Weekend, all one word. But we know that this weekend really is Victoria Day. And instead of doing the regular barbecue. And how much fun are barbecues really?
Barbecues are very fun and very delicious, and I don't have a barbecue.
I wanted to do something different, something that really recognized that it was Victoria Day. Because, you know, Victoria, Queen Victoria, London drugs, London. Plus, I didn't really do anything for the royal wedding, so I feel I need to make up for that.
So I had this great idea to do a high tea in honor of Victoria Day, except I don't know anything about high tea except there's tea. And I don't know the high part. So I live in Chilliwack, and what you do when you need to find out about something that's traditionally British, you go to Dickens Sweet Shop. So that's where I went. Let's go. Well, thanks so much for taking the time to talk to me today.
You're welcome.
What I really want to find out, in honor of Victoria Day, I've always associated high tea with very traditional Britain, Great Britain, British, and I'm in awe of it a little bit because proper manners, I don't know my way around it, so I thought that you could show us or tell us a little bit about how high tea came about and what we have here.
Well, high tea originated, I wouldn't know the exact year, I don't think anybody would, but it is the afternoon pick you up to keep you going until supper time, which is a little different than it would be here. It would generally be served a bit later than it is here. Lunchtime is what we have, is when we have our dinner. Now, when I was a kid going to school in Britain, that's when we had our meat and potatoes, was at lunchtime in school. And then after school, you would have sandwiches. Depending on your household, how fancy it would be or how plain it would be. And then later in the evening, you would have your supper, which you would call dinner here. So meals are just a little bit different in that you eat heavier earlier and lighter later.
So where does high come from then? Is that the time of day?
It's afternoon. It's the high point of the day. Like if you're starting, you know, your day at 7 a.m. and then there's like 3. It's just sort of the middle of the day where a lot of people think noon is, but noon isn't the middle of the day. It's the middle of the day if you're going to bed at 6.
Right.
Yeah. So it is sort of the high point of the day. And then you start going, you're tapering off.
High tea, it's a meal, so I can't go wrong. I'm not breaking any rules.
No, you can eat it.
This
part's hot.
Right.
So you really want to give it a bit of time to cool down. So I would eat, I don't know if it's the correct way of doing it, but my way of doing it would be sandwiches first, give this time to cool down. And then the dessert after.
And the dessert is always something sweet and a little bit of fruit?
Yes, on the top.
And the sandwiches, it looks like there's salmon and egg salad, cucumber.
Cucumber, cream cheese, and English cheese.
Oh, okay.
Which is a little bit stronger than normal.
And that's pretty traditional.
It does.
Now, is there a type of tea that is a must?
Oh, Yorkshire tea.
Yorkshire tea. I thought you were going to say Earl
Grey. Earl Grey is a choice of whether I personally do not like Earl Grey. It's the bergamot oil is quite perfumey, and if you don't like perfumey flavors in your tea, you're not going to like Earl Grey. Yorkshire tea is there's a chap in Yorkshire Harrogate is famous for its tea amongst other things. But the chap that puts together Yorkshire Harrogate tea is 7 blends. Now, tea can taste different depending on the time of the day it's picked, how many days it rained during the crop. Every how many hours the sun shone will change the flavor of the tea every season. So there's 7 different types of tea in Yorkshire Harrogate, and the taster at the factory where they produce it tastes up to 200 teas a day and can tell you when it was picked, whether it was raining or not, just by tasting it. I've seen this guy, he's totally amazing. And he takes a taste and spits it out and knows exactly. Now he, every year the Yorkshire tea is blended to taste exactly the same. It's astounding, he's astounding to watch. It's just long, 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 long tables of teacups that he tastes. It's just so the tea was worth more than gold.
Yeah.
There were ships built just to transport tea, but you know that.
I do now. Wow, I'm way smarter than I thought I would be after this. I thought I'd learn a little bit, but I've learned a lot.
Yeah, tea is a fascinating subject. Mm.
So I have a really important question for you.
Okay.
What of this, if anything, would go really good with a hockey game? What would you serve at a hockey game?
Well, hockey's not traditionally British.
Version of high tea. Now I don't really have any high-end china, but I have something that has flowers on it. I don't really have doilies, but I have paper towels, and I have snowmaking skills, so there's my doily. And the plates I have aren't really tiered like they were that Jean has, so I'm going to use this as a little bit of a base. And then I've got another doily, because I don't want the plate to slide. And now I've got this, which is actually a cup saucer, but it's the right size for the plates. So now I'm going to assemble the high tea itself. I'm starting out with some grilled tuna. I'm gonna put that over here. That's the warm stuff. Then I've got some nice homemade jam on pumpernickel, but of course you can buy that in the food aisle or in drugs. And then for the dessert part, I love shortbread, so I've got some shortbread pieces there and a couple of strawberries. So I also made another incredible find, because Jean mentioned having Yorkshire tea is the only tea. Let's show the name, Yorkshire tea. And if you'll notice on the label, it's from Taylor of Harrogate. So that dude who tastes all the tea, he tasted this tea. And to be quite honest, it's really delicious. And what made it even more delicious is it's in my Lenny Drugs photo mug. So cheers. I hope you have a great high tea or barbecue or whatever you're doing for the long weekend. And I hope the sun shines on your weekend too. Bye.